Look, the point is, it's a very simple thing. There are millions of people who live off our agricultural system. Large percentage of our people live off our agricultural system. These are laborers, they are farmers, they are small traders, these are these people. And they are the backbone of the country. Now, we understand that agriculture has to be reformed. What we are saying is that if you destroy this system, these millions of people will have nothing to do. They will not be able to feed themselves. And you will create massive destruction, massive pain in the country. Why is the Prime Minister doing this? It is a very simple calculation. The Prime Minister is doing this because he wants to help two or three business people. He does not care what happens to these people. He will construct whatever narrative he has to construct to make sure that the wealth transfer that is taking place to three or four people continues. He will call people terrorists. He will call people anti-nationals. He will call people criminals. He will do whatever he has to do to transfer the wealth from these people, the backbone of this country, to those people, three or four of them, five of them. That's the crux. And we are fighting this. We are saying that in India, where you have destroyed the agricultural system, will not function. Just like I said, take corona seriously. Corona is going to kill people in massive numbers if you do not act. At that time they said, you know, scaremongering. Now they're not saying scaremongering. When I suggested to the Prime Minister that do not do this in a centralized way, give power to the chief ministers, he didn't do it. He caused thousands and thousands of people to die because he didn't do it. And then afterwards, after I said it in the press conference, he did it. So the point is, you have an incompetent man who is controlled by certain other people. This is what India has to understand. This is what all youngsters have to understand. You have an incompetent man who doesn't understand anything, running a system on the behalf of three or four other people who understand everything. And their aim is to take huge amounts of money from the poor people of India and put it in their pockets. And that is what we are fighting. And frankly, it doesn't matter what you think right now, because all of you will face this. There's not going to be a single person in this country who's not going to face this. If you're a farmer, you will face it. You're a small businessman, you will face it. You're a journalist, you will face it. This is an assault on the idea of India. That is why we're standing here. That is why I've gone to the president. That is why we've signed these forms.
So you posted a tweet about Wydad yesterday about a family which was struggling while doing their farming. But there's several more instances like this. But the BJP is saying that this is just Punjab and farmers who are protesting here at the gate, delegate. No other farmer in the country has a problem with the reform.
That's just not true. That is just not true. We are not allowed to go out. We are not allowed to go out of the ICC office. The police stops us from going out. Why don't you let us go out? Why don't you let me go and tour in the states? See what happens. Every single farmer of this country, every single labor of this country, stand up. But aap police lagate ho, hathras jate ho, arrest karte ho, AIC se hamare MPs ko bahar nahi nikalne dete ho, aur phir kehte ho ki bhaiya, matlab sab kuch theek hai. Aur Prime Minister needs to realize that there is a limit to this. आपने थोड़ा सा करना है, आपने दो तीन लोगों की मदद करनी है, थोड़ा सा करना है, आप कर सकते हो. बट जिस प्रकार से नरेंद्र मोदी कर रहे हैं, मैं फिर से दोहरा रहा हूं, हिंदुस्तान के किसी भी युवा को रोजगार नहीं मिलेगा. सारे छोटे बिजनेस, सारे मिडिल साइज बिजनेस खत्म हो जाएंगे. और दूसरी बात याद रखिए, जिस चीज को आप सब भूल गए हैं, चाइना बॉर्डर पे बैठा है. चाइना ने हिंदुस्तान की हजारों किलोमीटर जमीन छीन ली है. प्रधानमंत्री उनके बारे में क्यों नहीं कहते? उसके बारे में चुप क्यों है? तो मेरा कहना है कि पूरा का पूरा कॉम्बिनेशन बन रहा है। एक तरफ आप अपने सिस्टम को तोड़ रहे हो, आप अपने लोगों को लड़ा रहे हो, आप अपने किसान को मार रहे हो, मजदूर को मार रहे हो, और दूसरी तरफ बाहर से फोर्सेस देख रही हैं, कह रहे हैं कि बहुत अच्छा है, नरेंद्र मोदी हिंदुस्तान को कमजोर कर रहा है और हमारे लिए अच्छी अपॉर्चुनिटी बनने जा रही है। मैं देश को बता रहा हूं, मैं वार्निंग दे रहा हूं कि आप देखिए क्या हो रहा है। और मैं आपको भी कह रहा हूं, प्रेस वालों को भी कह रहा हूं, मैं समझता हूं कि आपको सैलरी मिलती है और आपके लिए बहुत मुश्किल है, मैं समझता हूं बात, इसलिए आप नहीं कह पाते हो जो आपको कहना है, मगर आपके देश को, हमारे देश को बहुत जबरदस्त नुकसान होने वाला है। बहुत डेंजरस रास्ते पर यह देश चल रहा है, ये मैंने कहना।
कांग्रेस के नेताओं को डिटेन कर लिया गया है, आप लोग मार्च लेके यहाँ पर आ रहे थे, अभी जो है कांग्रेस के तमाम एमपी को इंक्लूडिंग प्रियंका जी को भी जो है डिटेन कर लिया, उसका
वो तो तरीका है, इनका तरीका है।
દિલ્હીમાં કોંગ્રેસ નેતાઓની અટકાયત રાષ્ટ્રપતિ ભવન સુધી પદયાત્રા કરવાના હતા, કોંગ્રેસના નેતાઓ જ્યાં પદયાત્રાની મંજૂરી ન મળતા કોંગ્રેસ કાર્યાલય પાસે જ કાર્યકર્તાઓએ કર્યા ધરણા, રોડ પર બેસી વિરોધ કરી રહેલા કોંગ્રેસના નેતાઓની પોલીસે અટકાયત કરી છે। કોંગ્રેસના નેતા પ્રિયંકા ગાંધી પણ ધરણામાં જોડાયા હતા। પ્રિયંકા ગાંધીની પણ દિલ્હી પોલીસે કરી અટકાયત। ખેડૂત આંદોલનના સમર્થનમાં કોંગ્રેસ સાંસદ રાહુલ ગાંધીની આગેવાનીમાં કોંગ્રેસની પદયાત્રાનું આયોજન। कोरोना महामारी ने आगर धरी, पुलिस से पदयात्रा ने मंजूरी नहोती आपी। कांग्रेस सांसद राहुल गांधी सहित त्रण नेताओं राष्ट्रपति साथे मुलाकात करी, 2 करोड़ खेडूतोनी सही वाला पत्रों राष्ट्रपति ने आप्या। कृषि कायदाना विरोध में खेडूतोनी साथे कांग्रेस होवानो राहुल अने प्रियंका गांधी नो दावो छे।
हमने 2 करोड़ किसानों के हस्ताक्षर इकट्ठे किए हैं जो हम राष्ट्रपति जी तक पहुंचाना चाहते हैं, ताकि वो जाने कि ये किसान जो बॉर्डर पे बैठे हुए हैं उनके साथ 2 करोड़ और किसान इस देश के लगे हुए हैं, कि पूरी देश की जनता उनका समर्थन कर रही है, सरकार को जानना चाहिए। और हमारा काम है, कर्तव्य है, एक विपक्ष के दल की होने के नाते कि हम किसानों की आवाज़ को उठाएँ, वही कर रहे हैं। सरकार को अपने एक्शंस की जिम्मेदारी लेनी पड़ेगी। सरकार 5 सालों के लिए, 6 सालों, 7 सालों के लिए नहीं चल सकती अगर आप सिर्फ विपक्ष को हर चीज़ की जिम्मेदारी दे रहे हैं। आपकी जिम्मेदारी है किसानों की आवाज़ को सुनना, आपकी जिम्मेदारी है, सरकार की जिम्मेदारी है। इस जनता के प्रति सरकार जवाबदेह है। देखिए, हल तब निकलेगा जब सरकार किसान की आवाज़ सुनेगी।